Bruker presents the timsTOF Pro and timsTOF Flex, ushering in the era of 4D proteomics and spatialomics. The timsTOF Pro was designed to address limitations in speed, sensitivity, and robustness of former proteomics instrumentation. Using trapped ion mobility, TIMS, and parallel accumulation serial fragmentation, PASEF, the timsTOF Pro ushers in the era of 4D proteomics through routine use of ion mobility to measure collision cross-sections, CCS. The timsTOF Pro uses a dual TIMS device to accumulate ions and separate them according to their mobility. The ions are released from the TIMS region by ramping down the voltage in 100 milliseconds. The mobility peaks are just a few milliseconds in width, yielding a revolutionary increase in speed and sensitivity. The next batch of ions is simultaneously accumulated in the first TIMS region, resulting in a nearly 100% duty cycle. 12 or more precursors from the next 10 TIMS scans are serially selected and fragmented by MS-MS in a data-dependent analysis, DDA workflow, resulting in a sequencing speed of more than 120 Hz. DDA workflows still suffer from the need to select individual precursors. Due to variations from sample to sample, the same precursors may not be selected in each DDA run. This means that not all of the identified peptides in one run will be comparable to other runs. This is known as the data completeness problem. Data independent analysis, DIA methods, were developed to solve it. In DIA methods, all ions in a given MZ window are fragmented in every run, so in principle, everything can be identified and compared from run to run. Bruker and our collaborators realized that a DIA approach using PASEF could take advantage of the correlation between ion mobility and mass. This technique, known as dia-PASEF, uses windows that start at high mass, as larger species elude at the beginning of the TIMS scan, sliding down to lower mass windows as the TIMS scan continues. dia-PASEF window schemes are at least four times more efficient in ion utilization than DIA on other instruments, and depending on the sample and window scheme, can be 100% efficient and very fast with unparalleled sensitivity.
So we have always known that DIA is the way forward and DIA is the future, but we have never really achieved the full potential of DIA until now when we added the ion mobility separation. So one of the big advantages of data independent acquisition is that it's reproducible and it's deterministic in its acquisition strategy. But one of the big downsides is that it produces a lot of data. Now, the timsTOF Pro and the ion mobility separation really makes this challenge much, much easier because it allows us to separate precursors within the same DIA window, and it allows us to assign fragment ions to precursors with much higher certainty. When we use the timsTOF Pro to perform dia-PASEF, it allows us to synchronize the quadrupole position with the elution in ion mobility. And this gives us a boost in throughput up to fourfold, getting four times as many ions into the detector. And this dramatically boosts the number of peptide identifications.
dia-PASEF technique provides conceptually and also in reality in advance. We have now a technique which can in one go, in one injection, identify and to some extent quantify more than 7,000 proteins from a tiny, tiny amount of material in the range of 100 to 200 nanograms of total material injected. And this allows us to get to really then determine differences between, let's say, healthy tissue and diseased tissue. And we know that the difference we observe are due to biological difference and not simply because a difference of which peptides were analyzed in one sample versus the other.
Bruker's timsTOF Pro and timsTOF Flex with PASEF and dia-PASEF continue the revolution in 4D proteomics.